So I'm working on this amazing flag game. Okay, you just need to detect the which flag. Okay, which flag is this? Like from which country? You need to detect the country. So if I put India and I'll see the check, click on submit, it'll see the correct answer. You can click on the next button to see the another flag here, and you can submit that answer too. So let's see how we can create this amazing app using MIT App Inventor. Okay, so how we can do this? So first of all, open the MIT App Inventor, click on new project. My project name is flag app new and click on OK. So I need here one layout. In the left side, you'll find the layout. Just drag and drop the vertical arrangement like this and make this height and width is fill parent like this. Okay, now what I need to do here, I need to click on the user interface and I need one image here to display the flag. I need another label to display the answer. I need one input box also. So you can see in the text box, this one, I'm going to put it up here like this. And I need one button for the submit answer. And I need one more button to go to the next flag. Okay, next question like this. Okay, I need all the things. And let's just set in the center. Click on vertical arrangement and just make it in a center and center like this. Now, I'm going to do one thing here. Click on the text for what label this is. And this is the answer. So I'll just put the text is like answer like this. At least 20 something. And make it font bold and make sure that text should be white. And I'm going to just make it black background color for the vertical arrangement like this. It's look perfect. Click on the image and you can see the width option. Just make it width is automatic, but the height should be that is 150 pixel. Like this. Okay. Now I need one more label here to make some difference between that image and that text box. Okay, so no one can see because that's the text color, that label text color is black, that's why. So I'm gonna add one more flag between both button like this. Okay, now click on that button and just change the width size is at least 70% like this. For the both button, I'm gonna just make it width is 70% like this. And one thing is like this button name is submit, so just change the text to submit, make it font at least 18, make it font bold, make it tag background color of that button to the pink. Cool. Another button name is like make it background color to something orange. For the next, change the text is like next, make it at least again 18. Okay, 18 and make it that font bold like this, or you can make it 20 like this. Okay, or 18 is fine. Cool. I'm going to just remove the label 1, label 3 value. I'm going to just make it the height is label 3, height is 1% or the 2% like this. So this is our overall app. Now we need the images. So you need to download the images from the internet. Like as you can see here, I'm downloading the images like this. Search and download it. Go to the MIT App Inventor. And I'm going to upload the all files. Click on upload file, choose file. And I have the flag of India, flag of Oman, and the US flag. Okay, so I'm going to just flag of India. Okay, upload it. Then again, upload file. And I'm going to do for all the flags. Oman. You can add the multiple flags here. Okay, there are a lot of like more than 200 countries we have. So you can just put any number of flags like this. Done. Now we have added the all flags, okay? And this is our the design part. I'm gonna just change the click on the screen and my app name is flag app, like this, okay? Let's go to the block section. Now, what I need to do, go to the design. I'm gonna just make sure that image should have some image. So I'm gonna just select that India flag like this. And it's look like this, cool. Okay, and you can see here that will look like this, okay? Cool, this is look like this. Amazing, it's like fine. I need some space between that both buttons. So I'm gonna just put that, click on that label as you can see here and make that height is at least 3% and okay. And see here you'll see the difference. Like see, amazing, fine. As you can see, hint for text box. I'm gonna just put here please put the country name or something, country name. So for the click on the text box and as you can see hint for this. So I'm gonna just change it to the country name like this, okay. If I just see here in the screen country name, cool, amazing, okay. So that's our overall app design. Let's go to the code part, go to the block. Now here, first we need to assign the one variable, okay. And that variable name is images, okay, or flag you can see, okay. And in that flag, we need to create one list. So click on list and see the mega list like this. Now, what we need to do here, we need to click on that image component like this. And scroll down, you'll see the flag is an image like this. Just drag and drop this like and copy paste 3 times because we have 3 flags only. You can add the multiple flags here. I'm going to just add this. And I need to just change India flag, then Oman, then the US. Like this. So we have a one list of all flags. Okay. Now we need to pick the random flag. So I'm going to use the procedure here. Okay. So whenever we call this procedure, so what I need to do, I need to just call the first random flag. Okay. To display that on that image. So set picture like this. So I need a random flag. So I'm going to just delete it. And I need a random. So what I'll do, I'm going to just use the here list. You see here option of pick a random item from which list? From the pick list. That is done. But now how we can add the condition and all the things? So it's very simple. Like what I'm going to do here, I'm going to add one more thing here. I'm going to add one, create one variable. And that variable name is like suppose. So I'm going to put the index. So this is the index value. Okay. So I'm going to assign that value to the maths and that value to the 0 for now. Now I need a value because whenever we select the random flag, so we need to know which flag is this. This is important. So how we will know that? We all know that the index value first is the 1, 2, and that is the 3. Okay. In the real programming language, like in the, Java or other, every time the count will start from 0. Okay. But here in MIT, we'll start a count from 1, 2, and 3 like this. Okay. Now, let's focus on how we can get that random picked image index value. So click on the list and you will see here the index in the list thing, this one. Okay. So how we can set that? Where we will set that index value? So I'm going to set that value in that index, like set. Okay. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to just index in a list thing. Thing means which we have picked. So I'm going to pick the random value, this one. Pick the random item from the list and I'm going to just put the again, here is the list like this. Now I have the number. Okay. And that number I will assign. So what I'll do, I'm going to just again copy paste this. Pick a random item and the item is the index. So I'm going to just delete it. Okay. And what I'll do here, I'm going to just assign the index value. So how we'll do that? Click on the list and see here, index, select a list item like this, call it. And list is like flag, this one. And the index is, index we have just said that. Suppose randomly we've picked from the list, suppose Oman, okay. So Oman is the item and here is the list. So Oman is a 2. So we have assigned the global index value 2. And then set image picture, select list item list. List is flag 2. Flag. Okay. And the index value is 2 because we have assigned a 2. So what that will pick overall procedure? The Oman flag. That will do the randomly. Okay. Done. Now we have. Now we need to write up, whenever we submit the first button, as you can see here, this is the button 1. Once we submit, suppose we put here India or suppose US. So how we will know that? So go to the block. Once the people click on the button 1. Like this, okay. And how this procedure will call? We'll call this procedure on the screen initialization, like this. When a screen will initialize, we'll call this procedure to display the flags. And once the people click on button 1, it means submit their answer. So we need to check. So for that, we need to use here the logics or the control, the if else. So I'm going to use here if. So click on math, and you will see here. Sorry, the logic, and you'll see the and. This is important. If and make sure I'm going to use the math and see the equal sign, this one, and like this. If that index value is equal to the 1, okay, and just call it here. If that, okay, index is assigned the 1, it means that randomly picked the Indian flag, okay, then that text box 1 dot text, that value should be equal to the India text. So I need to just check again math or equal sign, just copy paste. Text box 1.txt, that should be equal to the text, and that text is India. I'm going to just put the India like this. You got my point, right? Now, if it's done, if it's correct, both conditions. Here we are using the and. And means both conditions should be correct. Then that then will call. So for that, I'm going to just use here the label. Go to the design. I'll see the answer label name is label 1. So label 1. Label 1 text should like display here. I'm going to use text and just like this. And let's say here, correct answer. Right? Cool. Let's do for the two more times. Else if, and last one is else. So for the again else if, I'm going to use here this one. And if someone picked the index value is 2, it means text box value should be, here you can see the Oman. That should be Oman. Okay. And again, if someone picked that value to 3, or it's meant randomly, and that should be US. Suppose you can add the USA or US. And here I'm going to just set label like this. And correct answer, this is also correct answer. But if there is nothing is matching, okay, then we'll put set label value, wrong answer. Please, or try again. Please try again. Like this. Okay. That's it. That's really amazing. Cool. Now, we have one more button, and that is the button 2. Whenever someone want to, you know, just click on next button, we need to display again new flag. So we'll call that procedure again. This one procedure. Because in that procedure, we are calling the, you know, flag randomly. Okay. From our list. You can increase that list like this. Okay. Let's try. This is done. See the India flag. Let's put the India, suppose India here like this. Okay. And let's check this. Oh, wrong answer. Now, why this is? Let's try this, how this will work. See, text box 1.txt is done, India, okay? And 1 is also done, global index. But let me just check this 1 is assigned or not to the index value. How is this assigning? So, for that, first we need to do one thing, is click on the connect and make sure that should be refreshed. Okay? Now, just go here and see that is the Indian flag. And that is automatically assigned. Once we call the procedure screen in slice, global index, index value picked flag. Okay. Pick random value from the flag. And that is flagged. That is, you can see the India. Okay. Now let's put the India. And let's try this one. It should be correct. Correct answer, right? And I'm going to just do one thing. Let's click on the next. Next. See US. So let's put the US. Submit. Correct answer. Let's put the US TWO something and let's put submit. Wrong answer. Try again. Right? Click on next. See Oman like this. So you can test like this. Submit. Correct answer. So this is the overall app. Okay. So if you have any doubt on this, so just comment on the video. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye-bye.